talked there about important individuals, and we have a second award, which is for an individual innovator, the Standards and Innovation Innovator Award. Before I ask Vincent to reveal the winner, I'd like to turn to the wonderful Bryce to build up the anticipation for us again with his fabulous music. Over to you, Bryce. Much indeed. Vincent, who is the winner in the individual category?
It's working. So I am pleased to announce that the winner for the second category is Dr. Thomas Lehner from TUM.
Thank you very much indeed. Dr. Thomas Lehner, senior scientist at TU Munich, is its scientific director and became convener of the ISO Technical Committee. He couldn't be with us today because he is actually in Sydney at a plenary meeting of the Technical Committee. So he's very busy doing the work for which he is being honoured. But we have with us, and I'm delighted to welcome, hang on, we're going to hand over the award to Professor Dr. Thomas Bock, who is Director of Building Realisation and Projects at the Technical University of Munich. So he will collect the reward on behalf of Thomas Lehner. Both involved in the REACH 2020 project. You'll see information about it outside. And in a moment, I'll get Dr. Bock to tell us a little bit more about it. So congratulations. Thank you very much, Vincent, for doing the honours. No, don't leave. Don't leave. I would like you to come and have a chat with me, if you would. So congratulations to Dr. Lehner, but also to all of the team here, because we're hearing about really interesting projects and that teamwork and working togetherness. Dr. Bock, in terms of the role that standardization is playing and why individuals like Dr. Lehner have got involved, how important, you say a couple of words about the project and how important standards are.
Well, the project REACH is dealing with the aging society. So, anyhow, Dr. Lehner and I, we worked together since over 12 years, and also I established more than 20 years ago a new kind of division, which is very horizontal through the university. It's actually dealing with construction robotics, which doesn't fit in any kind of faculty. So we have a multidisciplinary team, and 4 years ago, we already included Dean into the submission of the research project, because it happened that about 25 years ago, I was involved in another ISO activity on automation of construction equipment. And I realized it's kind of stiff. You can improve excavators, tower cranes, tunnel boring machines, and so on. You can add sensors and make them more efficient. But in the end, it didn't help to improve the real estate sector. Now we have huge problems about exploding real estate prices, housing prices. People cannot afford to rent in Paris, in Barcelona, London, Milano, and so on. So the same happened when we went into the aging society. Actually, we are coordinating now mostly medical specialists, neurosurgeons, aged care homes, rehabilitation hospitals, And so therefore we also, from the beginning, from the onset on, we included DEAN, the standardization organization. And in the beginning we thought we can somehow use the existing standards. And then we found out, oh, then the same thing might happen with the construction machinery equipment. We just improve a little bit, but we cannot improve the whole system of the aging society, which will be a big challenge in Europe in the future to come. So then it was decided we set up a new standard. So the first strategic advisory group, it lasted for 2 years, from 2016 till 18, and then it resulted in the ISO, the TC314 aging society. So.
And your experience of the standard, you said you did it right from the beginning, so you were clearly aware of the importance of standards. You didn't need, we've talked a lot about awareness, but your experience of the process, how was it for you?
Of course it was positive, because also the research is already a kind of standardized research. We have different categories, disciplines, which we coordinate. We define the interface between the hardware, between the software, between different levels of applications, for example, from a university hospital in Geneva, through a care home, activity center, Eindhoven, and Copenhagen, through to the private home. So we have different levels. It's all standardized, the interfaces, the specific performances, and the processes. The process is actually very important. So. It's actually natural, because if you want to bring it into the market, then you already have to know the standards. Otherwise, it can never be introduced into the market.
And last question, one piece of advice for anybody who's thinking about getting involved in standardization but maybe hesitating. Do you have any advice based on your experience about how to take that leap?
The earlier you start, you need a different mindset. You have to open up your mind. For me, it was kind of easy, because I have three different backgrounds in three different fields. So it's in architecture, in engineering, and in robotics, from Germany, from United States, from Tokyo. So for me, it was easy to mix all these different fields and also different cultures. And different disciplines. So everybody has to open up. Just what was discussed this morning, we have to think horizontally. So we really have to also work horizontally. And then we can create new market opportunities. For me, it's not a contradiction if you research for market opportunities and at the same time you can be innovative. For example, I'm basically not a medical specialist. I'm also not a caregiver or something, but I just listen to the problem of the people.
Yeah.
And then I try to find solutions. So I think in the future we have to think about solutions to the future problems of the future society. And we have lots of problems. It's not just the aging society, it's what already mentioned from Professor Gonzalez, the sustainability and so on. Mobility, the new work, otherwise we're going to have a big unemployment, and we have to create new professions, new work, new mobility, and new sustainability for future.
It's that role of standards as a solution provider that we are focusing on here today. Ladies and gentlemen, will you join me in thanking Dr. Bock, congratulating Dr. Linna on the award?